Hello, I'm Thomas Rohde, Archbishop of Mobile. And I would like to share with you, the people of the Archdiocese of Mobile, that we're going to begin on the first Sunday of Advent, a special moment in our archdiocesan life, which I pray God will use as an instrument of His grace for all of us. We're going to observe for the next year, beginning on November 29th, the first Sunday of Advent, and going through the Feast of Christ the King next November, a year of the Eucharist and the parish, that we can focus on the priceless gift that God has given to us in the Eucharist and our call to be God's family, which we celebrate in our parishes. I'd like to begin with guidance, which we have all received from the Federal Centers for Disease Control and Prevention concerning the celebration of Thanksgiving this year. And the CDC has issued this. Thanksgiving is a time when many families travel long distances to celebrate together. Travel increases the chance of getting and spreading the virus that causes COVID-19. Staying home is the best way to protect yourselves and others. The CDC goes on to say that Thanksgiving should be celebrated preferably by, quote, having a small dinner with only people who live in your household and having a virtual dinner with others. Now, as much as this advice may be very necessary in our current situation with the virus, with this pandemic, Thanksgiving means more to most people than just having a virtual meal with family and friends. And I use this as an analogy for the celebration of the Eucharist, that so many of us right now are not at the Eucharistic table. People are not necessarily coming to church for the celebration of Mass because, understandably, they are concerned about their health and the health of their loved ones. And so a number of people are watching the Mass virtually. And I want to thank our priests who have been just extraordinary in making the Mass available online for people to watch, even if they can't come to church to be physically present. And I want to thank our priests who in many parishes are distributing communion before or after Mass outside of church for people who will watch the Mass online, but then come later to receive the Eucharist. And these are all praiseworthy for this moment. But there's something that's lacking in that, because we're not joining together to celebrate the Eucharist. To watch the Eucharist being celebrated is not the same thing as joining with the family at the table of the Lord, at the altar, any more than having a Thanksgiving dinner virtually is the same as joining together around the table with family and friends. I know that we pray that soon there'll be a vaccine that will make it safe for everyone to return to Mass. And so leading up to that moment when we can all return to the table of the Lord, we're going to observe this year of the Eucharist in the parish. And this has been on my heart for a long time because it's obvious that a number of Catholics do not understand the consistent, unbroken teaching of the Church that the Eucharist is real. It is the real presence of Jesus Himself. It is His body and His blood. And then there are sadly Catholics who know the teaching but do not embrace it. And so this is a time for us to reflect upon what has been the 2,000 year teaching of the Church about the real presence of the Eucharist, and to grow in an understanding and an appreciation to really take it to heart. And so I pray that this will be a year that will be observed in all our parishes, all our schools, all our Catholic ministries. You know, at the Last Supper, Jesus told us how he wanted to be worshiped. And he told us, have a meal. Take bread, take wine. This is my body. This is my blood. He calls us together to be together. And this unity that he calls us to gather as his family, is not just a human activity. It is an activity of the Holy Spirit. Mass is not just where God's people gather. It is where God gathers his people to be renewed and strengthened by the priceless gift of Word, the Bible, and the priceless gift of his presence. I mean, what more could Jesus have done to tell us that he is with us, nourishing us, strengthening us, traveling with us, than to actually allow us, his mere creatures, to receive his very body and blood into our own bodies? And so let's use this year to really grow in that understanding, appreciation of the Eucharist, and invite others into our parishes. You know, at Mass, we feast on God's gifts of Word and Eucharist that other people are starving for, even though often they don't even know this. And it's for us to make our parishes truly welcoming places where everyone feels welcome to come and join together as God's family. And so I pray that all of us will join together in this year of the Eucharist and the parish, as we really have this year, not as a program, not as task to be accomplished, but really to do what we're always called by the Lord to do. The Lord's call to us, ever ancient, ever new, is to be his people and to come together as his sons and daughters, and therefore brothers and sisters to one another. Let us ask our Mother Mary to pray with us that God will bless this year and that this will truly be a grace-filled time for each of us. God bless you and your loved ones.